feel it in his flow. Holy Spirit, move. 'Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Tear down every lie, set the wrong thing right. 'Cause when you have your way, something has to break. Something has to break. Right now in your name, something has to break. Something has to
in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you for being the creator, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for being the name above all names. God, we thank you for being a healer. God, we thank you for being a deliverer. We thank you for being a restorer. God, we thank you for being a provider, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we just thank you, Lord. We adore you right now, God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, have your way, God. We just thank you, Lord. We give you glory. We adore you, God. We take a moment, God, to move away from our troubles and just to give you praise. Thank God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. You said with my people who are called by your name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways. God, then God, you will hear from heaven and heal our land. So God, we send a prayer of repentance right now, God, in the name of Jesus. We're declaring that our land will be healed, God, in the name of Jesus. And God, we activate right now, God, we activate our keys to the kingdom in the name of Jesus, God. So we bind up sickness right now in the name of Jesus. We bind up disease right now in the name of Jesus. We bind it up right now. We bind up fear, God, in the name of Jesus. We bind up depression right now, God, in the name of Jesus. We bind up the spirit of suicide right now in the name of Jesus. We bind up doubt, God, in the name of Jesus, and reduce your glory, God, in the name of Jesus. In our homes, God, we loose your glory. In our living room, in our bedrooms, we loose your glory. In our office, in our workplace, we loose your glory. In our grocery store, God, we loose your glory, God, in the name of Jesus. So have your way, God. We loose your glory, God, in the name of Jesus. In the land of the living, we loose your glory, God, in the name of Jesus. We loose it, God. We loose your glory. We know where your glory is. There you are. There your healing is. There your deliverance is. There your restoration is. So we claim it today in the name of Jesus. Healing, God. Restoration, God, in the name of Jesus. Loose your glory, God. Loose it right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We give God praise on this Sunday morning. Come on and put your hands together and begin to bless the name of the Lord with us as we exalt the name of our God. How great is our God? Go ahead and get your family and your friends. Get them in the living room, in the kitchen, wherever you are. Come on, let's lift up the name of Jesus today. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? How Come on up, put those blessed hands together. Come on up, put those blessed hands together as we declare the greatness of our God. Come on, right there. Come on, Facebook corner, put up your lights. Go ahead and put up your lights. Come on, anybody love to praise him? Do you love to praise him? Go ahead and turn to your neighbor in your house and say, I love to praise his name. Hallelujah.
Reed,
we are the pastors here, and we want to take this moment to just welcome you to our virtual worship. We want to say thank you to the visitors for worshiping with us virtually. And so, visitors, you are welcome here at the Purple Church Miami virtually. Amen. Go ahead and put some hearts up, Purple Church members, and go ahead and just welcome our visitors to our Facebook page. It is time for the word. It's time for the word. Go ahead and grab your family. Go ahead and tell them to come into the living room, come into the family room. Wherever you are, you may be at the kitchen, in the kitchen cooking, and that's fine too. But wherever you are, go ahead and position yourself to receive. In these days that we know, and we still rely on God, we still look to God as the author and finisher of our faith. We want you to know that God is a healer. He is our portion. And he is more than enough for us. Hallelujah. Can you just, right where you are, just begin to worship and be able to just begin to honor the presence of the Lord. Honor the healer. Whatever you're going through, whatever situation you may be facing, whatever condition it is, know that God is a healer. Thank you, Jesus.
I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all I need. Yes, I do. I believe you're my portion. I believe you're more than enough for me. Jesus, you're all I need. I believe you're my
to know that there's nothing impossible for God. With God, all things are possible. Stand on that word today, that with God, all things are possible. Hallelujah. We believe you, God. We believe you, God. Hallelujah. We worship and we declare trust you, God. Nothing is impossible. word with you. Nothing is impossible for you. Hallelujah. So I stand here. I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all I need. Yes, I do. Oh,
for the grace.
Oh,
of the Lord will show up. God, in the name of Jesus, for the listeners who are out there in these traumatizing moments, I thank you, God, because this morning there is a notice on the door that says the church is still alive. The church is alive. It's not in a particular building, it's in the heart of a believer. And for somebody right now, they need this encouraging word. I pray for those persons who are watching us all around the country. Some are watching from around the world. I decree that God, the anointing will flow from this word into their situation. I thank you, God, because the world is looking to you again. And these times have pushed us back to the heart of God. I ask you right now, God, to be glorified today, that this message this morning will touch someone in a special way. And right where they are, yokes will be broken. I declare that right now, God, somebody on the airwaves, someone on social media, on Facebook, will meet you face to face. Somebody's going to get saved because of this word, and we give you the glory, we give you the honor and the praise in Jesus' name. Right where you are with your family, outside, inside, just say amen, amen, amen. I praise God. Today we're excited about being able to come to you through our virtual worship experience. We praise God for every one of you who are watching us right now online. I want you to take a moment, send out a post, connect, share this with somebody who you know from your family, friend, coworker. Let them know you're in church right now. And instead of them trying to text you or call you, they just need to chime on with you and be a part of this broadcast. And so certainly we thank God for all of you who are sharing with us right now. And we praise God for those who don't catch us on Sunday mornings. Every Monday, 12 o'clock, you can catch Pastor Reed on Faith Talk, Faith Book Live. We're talking to you about the faith and the power of God. Faith Book Live at AR Ministry Studios. And certainly, I'm grateful for how the Lord is allowing us in this season to use social media and technology to get the gospel out to the world. Praise the Lord. I praise God for so many of you who have been touching base with us all through the week. And those of you who don't have a church home, we're not going to push you to our church home, but we want you to find a church. You need to find a place. And those of you who have decided you're no longer stepping foot in the walls of a sanctuary, you got a church right here online. You might not come to us, we'll come to you. Praise God, because that's where we are in this 21st century. I'm grateful for this word that the Lord has placed in my spirit on this Sunday morning. And I want to direct your attention to the gospel. Actually, I want to direct your attention to Acts chapter 12, which is the life of the church after the gospel writers, after Jesus Christ had already ascended into heaven based on what the gospel writers said. He left us this story in Acts chapter 12 is where we're picking on the Acts writer today. But Acts chapter 12 is where you will find this word from the Lord. Acts chapter 12. And I want to start at verse 5, and then I'm going to throw a pebble and hopscotch to another verse, and I want you to follow along with me. I'm grateful for those of you who are not able to follow along as quickly. You can catch it on social media. You can rewind it. You can play it over and over again, and you can get this word into your heart. Acts chapter 12, verse 5. So Peter was kept in prison, but the church was earnestly praying to God for him. Let me read that again. So Peter was kept in prison, but the church was earnestly praying to God for him. Amen. Amen. Now, if you'll throw a rock with me, praise God. And if you will now jump to verse 12. When this had dawned on him, he went to the house of Mary, the mother of John, also called Mark, where many people had gathered, and watch what they're doing at the house, and they were praying, and they were praying. Peter knocked at the outer entrance, and a servant named Rhoda came to answer the door. When she recognized Peter's voice, she was so overjoyed, she ran back without opening it and exclaimed, here it is, you can say it together in your house, Peter is at the door. Peter is at the door. I want to preach this morning from the thought, God's stay-at-home order. I want to preach about God's stay-at-home order. These are very extreme times because never before in our lifetime have we had to deal with a stay-at-home order where you're not even allowed to worship in synagogues, churches, and other such places of worship. These are some extreme times because of COVID-19. People are afraid, and in the midst of the fear, people are concerned as to what will now happen to the church. And for some people who are used to going to church on a regular basis, you're already out of your norm. You're like a fish out of water. It's now been four Sundays, and for a lot of people, you miss the worship in the sanctuary. For those of you who are watching right now and who have no church home, but you remember how church used to be, I will contend with someone today that church as usual cannot be accepted. For I'm declaring to someone today that there is a reason why God has caused the sanctuary buildings to close, but the church at your house must stay open. There is something that the Lord is trying to teach us in this season, and I am concerned that we're missing the move of God because we're trying to go back to business as usual. I contend with someone today that the church is on lockdown. The church is locked up. And Peter, for those of you who know his story, he later on becomes the first bishop of the church. It is Peter who is symbolic of the lockdown by which the church is now operating. We're in a season now where the church is locked up. No choirs today. No usher boards today. No deacons singing songs today. Save your praise team and don't worry about your stewardess board because they can take off today. As a matter of fact, all over the country, all the norms that we did on Sunday morning, it has now been erased. We can no longer go back to how we used to do church. There is no reason for you to put on your Sunday's best because you could stay at home today. There's no reason for you to buy new shoes for church. Please don't worry about going to get your hair done or for the brothers trying to get a haircut right before the barbershop closes because there's no need to dress up to come in the sanctuary. Because what God is trying to do in this season is he is now calling for the real church to stand up. There was a season where everyone dressed up to get to church. Everybody wanted you to be involved in the materialistic outplay of what we call church. But I contend with someone today that if you're going to shout, you're going to shout in your living room. If you're going to praise God, you need to go ahead and praise God in your bathroom. For those of you who thought that church was about what we can see and the fanaticism of our faith, you got another thing coming today because the church is on lockdown. The building is closed, and all over the country, even men and women of God have been arrested and have been put in jail, all because they have been trying to have church as usual. I contend that what God is doing in this season is that God is shaking us up, and he is breaking away the stuff we thought was God, but it wasn't him. He is shaking us away from the materialism. He's shaking us away from being so comfortable on padded pews and listening to the hums of the organ and the beat of the drum and waiting for a man or a woman of God to tell you to praise God, to pump you up, to make you feel good. Can you believe it? Some people for years have dressed up just so someone could pump them up to praise God. But I'm shouting already for somebody who's in your living room, who's sitting on your couch, and you can feel Holy Ghost sitting next to you. I'm shouting for somebody who's sitting in your kitchen and the anointing's coming through your phone, the anointing's pushing through your iPad, through your Android, and you can feel Holy Ghost in your house. Some of you right now ought to just walk around your kitchen, walk around your house, walk around your garage and tell God, thank you that even though the buildings are closed, I can still feel you in my heart. I just want to shout for somebody right now, because while he's coming in your house, Satan's leaving out the back door. While he's coming in your house, enemies and demons are getting out your garage. While he's coming in your house, I can see your children hearing the word and gathering around you right now. While he's coming in your house, somebody right where you are need to just lift your hands in your house and let God have his way. Can I suggest to somebody in your house, in your driveway, you ought to declare right now, in the midst of this stay-at-home order, God, I thank you. Let God arise and my enemies be scattered. God, I praise you right now that right in my house, there is an anointing in this place right now. I can feel him in my house. I thank God. Today, I want to talk for a moment about this stay-at-home order. Number one, the church was on lockdown. Peter had been on lockdown. He had been in bonds. Watch this. Peter is on lockdown. The church is in bonds because it was trying to help other people get set free. And I contend with someone that anytime you're trying to set captives free, Satan will get on your track. Every time you're trying to liberate someone, trying to set somebody free, trying to build someone up, trying to get someone to their destiny, the enemy will get mad. But I like how this text opens up, because it opens up telling us that yes, Peter was in prison. King Herod had arrested some of the folk from the Baptist Pentecostal AME non-denominational church, and the Bible says they're actually intending to persecute them. But the Bible is very specific, because they recognize that Herod had already killed some people. When you get to verse 2 of Acts chapter 12, it said that Herod had killed James, the brother of John. He had put him to death with the sword. That's verse 2. But watch verse 3. When he saw that this met with the approval among the Jews, he proceeded to seize Peter. And this happened during the festival of the unleavened bread. But the Bible tells us that because of the festival, he was not ready to persecute and to kill Peter, because he would lose votes on election day. He would lose status. Matter of fact, his approval rating would go down. And don't that sound like somebody we know? Always playing into the people. Isn't that like someone we know from 1600 in D.C.? Isn't that just like someone we know? Number 45, always playing into his base, always saying things to please his base, even if it's racial, even if it's misogynistic, even if it's homophobic, always saying something to please his base. But I can tell somebody today that it does not matter who's in the White House. What matters is who's moving around your house right now. And the Bible says that now Herod was trying to please his base. And while Herod was trying to please his base, look at what verse 5 says. Herod wants to please his base, but Peter was kept in prison. I like this, because while Peter is in prison, the church is praying. While Peter is locked down, the church is praying. While Peter is suffering from being put in bonds, the church is praying. Can I please shout for somebody right now? Some of you in your house ought to be telling God, I thank you for the people who prayed for me. I thank you for every person who called my name in prayer. Isn't that just like God, that when we are at the pit of destruction, God will always put an intercessor there. He'll put somebody who, he'll put you on their mind. He'll tell them, start burning the midnight oil. I wish I could shout, but I'm at the church and you're at your house. You might as well touch and agree with your children, with your family. Some of you, the doctor gave up on you, but the church was praying for you. Some of you could have been dead, but the church was praying for you. Some of you were down to your last dime, but the church was praying for you. Somebody prayed for me, had me on their mind, took the time to pray. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I'm so glad they prayed. Somebody ought to be walking around your bathroom saying, God, I thank you I don't have cancer because the church was praying for me. Some of you ought to walk around your car and say, God, when my credit was messed up, I thank you because somebody was praying for me. Can I take 10 seconds? Get in your living room. Start praising God. Don't worry about being recorded. It's just you and God in your house. Open your mouth and shout, God, I thank you that somebody prayed for me. Hallelujah. I thank God I don't have a crowd here today, because I can shout as long as I want. I'm praising God because when I almost lost my mind, somebody was praying for me. Watch what happens. The more the church prayed, the more God started moving. The more the church prayed, the more cancer started leaving. The more the church prayed, the more children came back home. Watch this. The Bible says while they are praying, an angel shows up in prison. Look at this. Isn't that just like God? That when you start praying, he'll send you help. It may not come when you call him at first, but God always shows up on time. The Bible says while the church is praying, the angel comes to Peter and says, Peter, get up. And when Peter gets up, the Bible says that although he gets up, when he gets up, the chains fall off. I want to praise God for every intercessor in my life. I want to praise God for every intercessor God puts in your path. Because the more they pray, the more chains will fall off. Some of you got chains on your credit report. I declare it's going to fall off. Some of you got chains on your finances. You're tired of being denied. Tired of people telling you you can't do it. But I declare in the name of Jesus, the chains are about to fall off. I can hear it right now. Some of you got chains worrying. Is COVID-19 coming to your house? Is that sneeze a symptom? Is that cough a symptom? I've come to tell you that the vaccine is already there. If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will I forgive them, hear from heaven, forgive their sins, and heal the land. I hear the Lord saying, church, it's time to pray. If you never prayed before, grab your children in your house, shake them and tell them, wake up. Tell them it's praying time. If you never prayed with your husband, prayed with your wife, prayed with your boo, grab them right now. Tell them we've got to pray, because the chains have got to fall off. Watch what happens. happens, the Bible says, the angel starts leading him. When you pray, God starts leading. Watch this. I can see God right now. God shut the church down, put us on lockdown for a season because he wants us to pray at our homes. And while we're praying at our homes, God is now leading the church back to the heart of God. Too many churches have been so fanaticized. Too many churches have started worshiping people. Too many pastors have started watering down sermons because they want to please people. Too many pastors, too many churches have started doing what's popular and not what's prophetic. Too many churches have been enjoying crowds, nice pews, nice air conditioning, beautiful steeples. But while we were being a part of capitalism and faith-based money, that stuff has been moving us away from the heart of God. We've been coming to church and St. John's and Stacy Adams, sitting on apple bottoms, but we've not been praising God. It takes 500 people until you get up and start clapping. It takes 500 preachers until you start waving your hand. God said, in that case, I'll let you stay home. Show me how you praise me at your house. Because if you can't praise me at your house, then I don't want to hear what you got to say when you come into corporate worship. I wish I had a believer in your home who can say, God, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul will make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Tap two or three of your loved ones and say, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Can I get a witness out there? Somebody ought to just stand up in your front room and say, God, I thank you. Just come what may, my hope is in you. I praise you anyway. Watch this, watch this, watch this. I know for somebody, you're cooking food. You hadn't eaten breakfast yet. I got to get through this. I need to give you some soul food so you can live for the rest of the week. Watch what happens. The Bible says in verse 12, when all of a sudden he has been released, right in your house, declare release. I need to hear it again in the atmosphere. All over the country, somebody say release, release. The Bible says after they had been praying, and while they had been praying, there was a release. Much prayer, much power. Little prayer, little power. No prayer, no power. While they're praying, God is working a release. And when the release happens, the Bible says, although Peter don't know where he's going, he's following the angel. I hear the Lord saying to tell about 100 homes that while you're praying, there is now an APB that's going out to your loved ones who don't even know Jesus. God said they don't even know that while you're in the house, he's going to move from your house to their house. Some of your loved ones are on crack. Some of your loved ones are prostitutes. Some of your loved ones are battling with all sorts of issues. But God said, I'm sending angels right now to keep them in the way. I wish I had about 50 prayer warriors who can declare right now for your cousins who are on the corner. God is about to bring them back. For your auntie at the nursing home, God is speaking, she shall live and not die. The Bible says that now there is a release. I feel it in my spirit this morning. Somebody shout, release, release, release. Come on, get it in your spirit. Release, release, release. I hear the Lord saying that whatever you've been praying for, there is about to be a release. I'm not talking about your stimulus package. I'm not talking about your small business loan. I'm talking about some spiritual things that's been in the atmosphere for a long time. God said to tell you that if you lift
lift up some prayers. He's getting ready to send it on down. Somebody shout, release, release, release. I dare you point to your children and declare, release, release, release. Some of you need to point to your loved ones who have turned their backs on the church and declare right now, release, release, release. Some of you need to go touch your pocketbook. Go touch your wallet and declare right now, release, release, release. The Bible says that when Peter got released, he went to the house where the same people, the same folk who had a tarrying service, the same people who were believing God that we may not be where Peter is, but we'll pray till God release. I dare about 500 homes start declaring right now for the CDC and the government to release the church. I declare in the name of Jesus, I speak right now. I call those things, although they be not, as if they are. Somebody shout, release. The moment you said release, God said, I'm bringing things that you prayed for 10 years ago. It's coming to pass. Somebody shout, release. He said, the moment you said release, the doors of your job, it just opened. Somebody shout, release. God said, the blessing that you thought was for somebody else, it is for you. Somebody shout, release. I see God opening doors for your children. I see scholarships for your family. Somebody shout, release. Open your mouth right where you are. Let your neighbors hear you. Let the folk down the street hear you. Right in your house. Open your mouth. Shout, release, release, release. Watch this, watch this. When Peter gets to the door, Peter starts knocking. He starts knocking. He starts knocking, knocking, knocking. And the Bible says Rhoda came to the door. When Rhoda got to the door, the Bible says Rhoda is so overjoyed that she forgot Peter was at the door. I hear the Lord saying to tell you, if you can start shouting in your house, whatever's at the door is about to come through. I dare about 10 of you, right where you at, go walk to your door. Get ready, get ready. Because at your door, there's getting ready to be a breakthrough. Getting ready to be an overflow. Getting ready to be a double portion. Open your mouth. It's a stay-at-home order. Well, while you're in your house, give him praise. Give him glory. Yeah. Give him a shout. It's at your door. Start praising. Don't wait till you get to church. The church is right where you are. Give him a shout of hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I thank God. I'm not preaching for you. I'm preaching for myself. I'm declaring right now, everything I prayed for is getting ready to come through. Everything that was locked up, there is a release. I can't wait till the battle's over. I got to shout right now. I dare you, in your front room, in front of your TV, give him praise. Yeah, give him praise. God said, there's a stay-at-home order. And the Lord said, if you want the church to get a release,
You got to start praying. If you want a release to come upon the children of God, right now, buildings are locked. Some of you wanted to go to church. You wanted to go to a church building, but you couldn't. Some of you right now, you miss sitting on the pews, getting dressed up, and God said, I'm going to save you some money this month. You don't have to get dressed up for me. Praise me right where you are. For somebody right now, you don't understand why things have happened the way they're happening, but God said, I need the church to stay at home for a moment because I need you to get back in the posture of praying again. Now, you got to be careful. The Bible says they're at Mary's house, and Mary didn't have everybody there. Mary had just a few people, Rhoda and a few others who she knew how to pray. Got to be careful who you let in your house. Got to be careful who you allow to dine with you. When times get rough like they are right now, you need people who know how to pray. People who can tell you, we'll keep on praying until we see the miracle. We'll keep on believing until the manifestation of it starts knocking. And I believe, God, right now that this stay-at-home order is to get the church back to the heart of God. I mean, think about it. A lot of times people have strayed, people washing cars on a Sunday when it's normally their day of worship. Some of you right now, there are other things and other plans you had for the last month. God killed all your plans just because he wanted you to focus back on your home. He wanted you to invite his spirit back in your house. He wanted you to know that he's not just the God of the church building. He is the God of the church that's in your living room. So I want to pray for some people right now. And I'm believing God for each and every one of you. For somebody right now, drop to your knees in your house. I see you. I don't know who you are. I hear the Lord saying her name is Angel. Whoever you are right now, drop to your knees right now, full of repentance. Robert, you too, drop right where you are. God says, you strayed, but now come back home. I'm praying for you right now. I'm praying for you. I don't know who you are, but they call you sis. Sis, right where you are, on your knees, just say, Lord, I'm sorry. For somebody else, you're at the verge of overdosing, but God said no. And I'm declaring right now, several of you, I'm praying for you. God said the anointing's coming through your phone. God said the anointing's coming through your TV. This is not fake. This is something you feel. You feel it right now. That word was for you. God said, I've been calling you for the longest. Several of you, you've got ministry on you. You've got a ministry. But you've been sitting on the side. You've been allowing everybody else to go before. And God said, no. In this season, I'm raising up a generation who's not all about being dressed up, but they're about being praised up. I'm lifting up somebody right now who there is a breach in your home. You've been disappointed. You feel left out and left behind. Your own family have tried to make things hard for you, but God told me to pray for you today. God said, you're the person that when the church building opens again, you're going to come. Some of you are going to come right to this purple church. And God said, you're going to come and you're going to tell everybody, on that Sunday, I gave my life to the Lord while I was listening to the pastor. My soul became anchored in God again. I'm praying for somebody right now. Several of you are on your knees. And then I'm praying for that grandmother right now. She's not on her knees. You can't get on your knees because arthritis and pain has struck your body. But I came to tell you today, you don't have to be on your knees. Just sit on your favorite couch and just say, Lord, I'm yours. And as you say, Lord, I'm yours, God is going to remind you that he never left you. He was there all the time. I see several of you right now, you're crying. Let the tears out. It's okay. It's healthy. Don't worry about people watching you. Guess what? Filter your soul. God said there is about to be a release. For some of you, COVID-19 has caused them to release your loved ones out of jail. And the Lord said to tell you today, they will live and not die. I speak over every one of you who've got great things bottled up in you. God said, I needed you to take time to write the vision. That's why I closed down your job, because I needed you to spend time with me. That's what the Lord said. God said, you've been writing like never before. He said, now after I open things up again, I'm going to send you money to make things happen. I'm praying for several of you right now, and all of you who are going to post this, make sure you don't cut out this part. God says to tell over 1,000 of you, he still loves you. That's all God said. God said, this is not a long letter. For the people who were just church hopping, God said to tell you, that's not what it was about. God said to tell about 1,000 of you, I still love you. You had drifted away, started making money. You thought that you could just slip and slide on God. God said, I'm a jealous God. God said, I never will share you with somebody else. So God said to tell you one more time, he's going to use my mouth just to say to you, God said, I love you. And for somebody, that's all you needed to hear this morning. You needed to hear that God still loves you. For those of you who are posting it, make sure you send that out. God said, I love you because I see something in you. I see something so great, the world can't destroy it. God said, I'm not finished with you yet. God said, don't you dare throw in the towel. God said, I'm just getting started. I declare to somebody right now, I'm praying a prayer to cover your house. Your money is messed up. It ain't funny, it's just messed up. And the Lord said to tell you, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. There's an adding that's about to take place in your life. Hallelujah. I'm excited about that. Father, in the name of Jesus, those of you who are on your knees, those of you who are on your couch, stretch your hand out if you can. Close as you can get to me. Touch the TV, touch the iPad, touch the phone. And if you're just listening, just listen real closely. This prayer says, Lord, I come to you. You know me. And God, I pray now that you forgive me of all my sins, creating me a clean heart, renewing me a right spirit. I want to be right with you, God. Have me, God. Take me, God. Do what you want to do with me, not what I want to do. God, today I will be your witness. I will prove to the world that God is alive. So in the name of Jesus right now, God, thank you for that word. I thank you for this stay-at-home order. It has pushed me back to the heart of God. I love you and I give you all glory, all praise in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Watch this. Real quick, there's somebody who wanted to give their life to Christ. Look how quick you can do this. Lord, I'm a sinner. Have mercy on me. I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe in my heart, God, you raised Jesus from the dead. With that power, raise my life. Thank you for another chance. And then, God, fill me with the Holy Ghost. I need Holy Ghost power. If you do that, God, today is a new day in my life. In Jesus' name, for that person who prayed that prayer with me, you are saved. You've been purchased by God. The blood has signed your name. Thank you, Lord. Angels are having block parties in heaven. And guess what? Up in heaven, they don't have to stay 6 feet apart. They can be right up on each other celebrating your victory. So I give God the glory for that. Somebody right where you are, I want to take 30 seconds right where you are. Put your hands together. Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him, praise Him. Oh, you are to praise.
come on, for about 10 more seconds. You are to praise him. Yes, just praise his name. Give God the glory. Hallelujah. Give him glory right now. Hallelujah. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. There's no harm. That's your house. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Come on, right in your house. Praise. One more time, come on. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Give God the glory. 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 He's worthy. 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 Can you just shout with me? Worthy, 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 worthy. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. He deserves the praise. Listen. Here is a couple names the Lord just dropped in my spirit. Michael. God has work for you. Keisha, it ain't over till God says it's over. Tanise, God said, I love you. Don't you turn your back on his work. Sherry, it's not finished. The plan of God is to move you to another level. Arthur, don't you ever think that you're by yourself. God said, he's the author and finisher of your faith. And I declare in the name of the Lord Jesus now, Pat, Brian, Charles, move forward in God's glory. Everything you went through was to get you to your next stage. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen, hallelujah. Listen, this is what I want you to do. I praise God for the glory that I feel. I feel it here. You must be sending back some positive, powerful energy. I want every one of you, if you get the chance, put some likes up there right now. I see you're sending positive energy. I know some positive energy is coming from this way. And I know good and well that there's some positive energy coming from your way. This is what I want you to do. I don't want you to miss the power of residual blessings all because you don't give while the doors of the church building are closed. I want every one of you to do something special. I want you to go find the best offering you can. You're going to find a major seed right now. You're not going to give the seed that you were planning on giving. You're going to go to the other drawer, to the other closet. Amen. Wherever you hide your money around your house, you're going to go find a major seed. You're going to find a seed of faith. This is a seed that's going to make you say, oh, I didn't plan to do it, but man, I thank God for that word. And I thank God for what I feel in my house. Now, if you don't feel anything in your house, don't you give anything. But if you know you feel the anointing flowing in your house because of that word, because of the worship, I want you to sow into this ministry. Go find a major seed, a seed that stretches you. Somebody right in your house say, stretch. Some of your children are saying, stretch, mama, stretch, daddy. Amen. I want you to stretch right now. Go find a seed that will stretch your faith. I'm declaring right now, tenfold, whatever you sow today, tenfold. I'm asking God to bless you with it back. Tenfold, not the same amount, tenfold. And it may not come financially. It may come with just a decision that God allows the doctor to make or a decision the judge will make on your behalf. It may actually come when your grandchildren stand in the financial aid office when school opens up. God will stretch you today. Stretch out on faith. Listen, here's how you do it. Go to Giblify. Those of you who are the Giblify crowd, go find Martin M. Inc. Martin M. Inc. on Giblify and sow
a seed that stretches your faith. When you sow, say, Lord, I'm stretching. Then you sow. Then those of you who are the Cash App crowd, I know a whole lot of folk are Cash App and Venmo. Watch this. For the Cash App crowd, $ Purple Church. Go find it as fast as you can. Don't you let the economy stop you from the expansion of your faith. I'm declaring in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you are taking the seed you have out of your hand and putting it in God's hands. Watch what God will do with your seed. He'll take a little and make much. I'm a witness. I'm a believer. Some of you went to the car lot. Your credit was jacked up, but God bless you anyway. You walked there, but you drove off the lot. Amen. Some of you right now, God used faith to bring your house off of foreclosure. Amen. Some of you right now, you were scheduled to appear before the judge, and you know you were guilty, but watch what God did. God put people in place to intercede on your behalf. God blessed and touched the judge, gave the judge a good attitude, and you were given a second chance. Why not step out on faith? Sow a seed right now. I want you to take the next 10 seconds. Sow that seed. Sow it. Don't you miss it. Sow a seed that speaks of your faith. The Bible says the difference between Cain and Abel was Cain brought God whatever he wanted. Abel brought God his best. And I believe that's what God is calling the church to do, to give his best, not secondary. God wants to be primary. God doesn't want to be a half lover. He wants to be your full lover. Why not stretch out on faith? Purple Church, do it on Cash App. Give LaFi Martin Memorial, Martin M. Inc. Amen. Wow. God is amazing. I'm praising God for what the Lord is doing. Next Sunday, somebody shout in your house, next Sunday. I hear you. The echoes all through the nation, is all through the country. Next Sunday, I want you to meet me at 11 o'clock a.m. right after our virtual worship. I want you to come to 14740 Lincoln Boulevard and get your communion. I want you to come and get the body and blood of Jesus. Next Sunday is the first Sunday in May. And as my mom always said, if the Lord spares life, I want you to meet us right outside in front of the church at 11 o'clock a.m. for our drive-through communion worship experience. Our drive-through communion. You will have the chance to be a part of the broken body and blood of Jesus. After we've consecrated it, we look forward to having not only the members of our church, but you can come if you're a member of another church, because Jesus said, do it as often as you shall in remembrance of him. We will never withhold communion from somebody, because it's the Lord's table and it's the work that the Lord wants us to do. I want to see your face coming through our parking lot on next Sunday at 11 o'clock a.m. where you will have the chance to receive the body and blood of Jesus at our virtual worship experience and our drive-through communion. What a wonderful Sunday it is. What a beautiful day it is to be alive. I've enjoyed being here. I've enjoyed being invited into your home. Thank you so much. As they say on the commercial, they'll leave the lights on. Thank you for leaving the lights on for us. But I want to tell you that the light that you left on is the light that Christ placed in your life. When he said, let your light so shine before men that they might see the good works and glorify the Father which is in heaven. There is a light inside of you. This is about to be the best week of your life. Now, as I stretch my hand forth, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with you at your stay-at-home order. May he bless you real good. This is going to be the best week of your life. May he keep you and bless your home. I'm reminded what Joshua said. Do whatever you want to do, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. God bless you. God keep you is our prayer. God loves you. So do I. We'll see you real soon. God bless you.